Bill Tyson, who lives in Media, volunteered as an emergency medical technician with the Media Fire Company for 20 years. He also served 4 years as the fire company president, overseeing all the administrative functions of the organization. Bill has contributed to the community by serving on the board of the Delaware County Chamber Foundation, as well as on the board of the Media Theater.
Bill Tyson has lived in Media for 30 years, and he was elected to 2 terms on Media Borough Council, where he participated with the historical and library boards and supported changes in borough codes to preserve Media's small-town character. Bill's currently the president of the Delaware County SPCA, where he's helped to improve operations. The SPCA serves the entire county, taking in nearly 8,000 animals per year. The organization is approaching its 100th anniversary.
Bill is the director of public affairs at Aqua America, as well as an instructor of public relations and communications at Penn State Brandywine. He lives in Media with his wife Julie and their dog Flash.
For countless hours of volunteer service over the years, for dedication to our community, for his contributions to making Delaware County a better place, we're proud to spotlight Bill Tyson. To nominate a Delaware County resident for the Citizen Spotlight segment, please visit the feedback section of our website, DelcoMostWanted.com.
Delaware County's Most Wanted. Charles Koslowski, last known address, Newtown Street, Allentown, wanted for probation violation, charged with aggravated assault and criminal conspiracy. Anthony Curlew, last known address, Spring Avenue, Ardmore, wanted for probation violation, charged with possession of a firearm without a license. Rita Leonti, last known address, Booth Drive, Booth Wynn, wanted for probation violation, charged with forgery, theft by unlawful taking, felony retail theft. William Frank Elliott, last known address, Morris Avenue, Crumlin, wanted for probation violation, charged with possession of a controlled substance. Felix Luna Santiago, last known address, Cadwaller Street, Philadelphia, wanted for probation violation, charged with forgery. Jacob Saladini, last known address, Springfield Road, Springfield, wanted for probation violation, charged with resisting arrest, possession of drug paraphernalia. To make anonymous reports or for more information, call 1-877-R-WANTED or visit DelcoMostWanted.com.
Crazy Criminal of the Week, sponsored by Enrique Latoyas and InTroubleWithTheLaw.com.
Time now for our Crazy Criminal of the Week. And Sheriff, this edition actually features not one, but two criminals, and it's a mother and son team. We head down to Naples, Florida, at a neighborhood Kmart. That's where 19-year-old Corey Dalton and his 38-year-old mom, Lori Lynn LaRoque, were doing some shopping, so to speak, the five-finger discount variety.
Going for the deals.
You see, Sheriff, mom and son were caught shoplifting some merchandise and were quickly nabbed by a loss prevention officer. But as they were being escorted to an office, the son yelled, "Run, Mama, run." And mom did just that, took off, fleeing the store, son following as well. They jumped into their getaway Cadillac. However, they were far from in the clear because this dynamic duo made it easy again for authorities. They left behind the mother's debit card and also $13 of stuff they actually purchased legally. Cops found the pair a short time later at the son's home and arrested them both, charging them with petty theft. And as we often see in these cases, this wasn't their first bout with the law. Dalton, the son, had an arrest warrant already for failure to appear in court on a marijuana charge. So again, they're making it easy for you guys.
Yeah, they are. They actually, some of them make it easy. But as you can see, it's important that if you're going to be on the other side of the law, so to speak, you have to stay in shape.
Yeah, we don't know the condition of the cop, the Kmart cop, if it's a Paul Blart deal or not. But, you know, now let me ask you this. Have you seen this a lot where when you finally do get to these people, they have another warrant out or there's something else, so you kind of, you know, hit the jackpot, so to speak, legally, as far as, oh, we got a guy who we already needed to get.
Yeah, no doubt about it. There, we have a frequent flyer program as well in the law enforcement community. So, yeah, we have multiple crimes being done by the same person. It's great. Probably the same 80-20 rule that it is in everything else in life.
All right. We'll have another crazy criminal next show, no doubt. Plenty to choose from.
The Law Office of Enrique Latoyson. You can expect prompt, on-time, professional, and courteous services. We understand that how we represent you is a reflection on you choosing us as your attorney. At the Law Office of Enrique Latoyson, we can assist you with DUIs, felonies, misdemeanors, juvenile cases, bench warrants, traffic stops, expungements, and much, much more. We understand that occasionally bad things do happen to good people, and we've been carrying on a family tradition in Delaware County for over 100 years. The Law Office of Enrique Latoyson.
Another edition of Delaware County's Most Wanted in the books. Chester County Mayor Wendell Butler, our great guest, and really, Sheriff, a true American success story, the way the mayor has continued to build himself up and achieve success.
Yes, he really has been a part of the American dream, so to speak, and he's doing an excellent job here as the city's mayor. There's so much going on and so many different fronts, and how he's able to just adjust to keeping track of everything is quite amazing.
Yes.
Especially, you know, he's no spring chicken. So he has all that experience to work in his favor, and he's utilizing it very nicely.
You say this after he leaves, but okay.
Yeah.
And, you know, taking a look here at briefly at PPL Park with the mayor, stay tuned to our program as the weeks go by, because we're going to do a full episode here from the park as well, and I know you're looking forward to that.
I am. And thank you, Mayor Butler, for inviting us down to the city of Chester, and what a place to really film the show at. And I'm looking forward to coming back. How about you?
Absolutely. Looking forward to it, no doubt. And remember, if you have any information regarding any of the fugitives featured on this program, don't hesitate to call us. 877-R-WANTED is the number. 877, the letter R, WANTED. You can also access our website, DelcoMostWanted.com. And we welcome your feedback regarding the program as well. Any questions or comments are appreciated.
Yeah, and more importantly, I hope that all of our viewers will remember to support our advertisers. Our sponsors of the show are really our lifeline. And this is the way that we keep the show running without any taxpayers' money whatsoever covering the cost of the show. So if you could let our sponsors know that, hey, you've seen them on the Most Wanted show, then they'll continue to support us, and we'll continue to be able to bring venues like this. So thank you very much.
Absolutely. Well, thank you again, Sheriff, for another great program. For Sheriff Joe McGinn, I'm Kevin Shola. We hope you join us again next time here on Delaware County's Most Wanted, as a viewer, of course, and not as one of Delaware County's Most Wanted.
I'll meet ya.